version of myself I need to deal with you. So some things you have to leave in the hood, and I'm just keeping that real.
Repeat that. You said that real fast.
Okay. Yes. When I meet you, it lets me know what version of myself I need to deal with you. So when we're in the hood, hey, we're going to speak that hood language. The hood shit. You know what I'm saying? But when we go into the corporate office,
by our own negative influences. Some of our members, their parents were involved in the gang life. Luckily, mine weren't, but mine were struggling immigrant parents trying to make it out here in the city of Pacoima against all odds. And so we really didn't have many avenues, many platforms to actually be able to get out there. As you all know from the hip-hop history lesson we just had, hip-hop was created out of underprivileged communities that didn't have the opportunities to engage in these civic activities, going out to your Boys and Girls Clubs that we call now. We didn't have that, so we had to take to the streets. Same goes out here in this little small town of Pacoima. And in coming together in high school and really realizing that we had to do something for our community, that we couldn't just wait for someone to come in and do something for us, we built and formed the Great Whatevers. Because the idea was that if gangs and gangsters can go ahead and run amok without asking for any permission to do whatever they want in a negative fashion, then we should be able to spread positivity without asking for permission and do as we please to spread that positivity and success to our youth. And so at the end of the day, the Great Whatevers didn't start to make money, and money has never been the bottom line or the motive. The motive has been to empower and uplift our community. And out of that was value was created, as we spoke about before. Sticking true to your guns, sticking true to the fact that we were here spreading positivity, we started off first meeting, and my boy right here, Eric Chapman, Rock Swift is another co-founder, so he can tell you too, that we were together sitting across the table from politicians, and to some degree we were kind of taken as a joke. It was like, oh yeah, I remember when I was a little DJ back in the day, laugh, 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 chuckle, chuckle, nothing comes out of it. And we're here, kids from Pacoima, from the hood, trying to better the hood, but nobody's paying attention. So guess what? That's when we took it to the streets. That's when we took it to the parks. That's when we started to organize our fellow youth and our fellow peers to come together and embrace this culture of hip-hop, and more than anything, embrace ourselves. Because hip-hop is nothing but a conglomeration of cultures, of cultural aesthetic practices, of cultural practices in general, dance, art, love, all these different things are formulated. And because we've been stuck to those guns and spreading that positive message of hip-hop and staying true to our roots and our community, we've been able to excel. Now we have members, right now actually, we have a member in Shanghai. Next month, we're going to Mexico. Some of our members are going to Japan. For what? To spread this culture. Some of us may be making money off of these trips and tours, the little that we do make to survive, to get some bread on the table. But the bottom line is not the money. It's not the fame. It's empowerment. It's creativity. And that's where we stand strong. And I think that's what I took from the last conversation. The value is something that you build yourself by staying true to yourself. Whether that's being jiggy, whether that's being really hood, whatever it may be, if you stick true to your guns, you will make it. Everyone has a place in this world, and everybody has a place in hip hop. And I'm a firm believer in that.
So I tell you the truth, really. Me not gonna need nothing else but health, wealth, and knowledge of myself. Me not gonna need nothing else but health, wealth, and knowledge of myself. In the beginning was the word was made flesh. Knowledge K, reigns all, supreme S. Some of us guess while others of us are blessed. Take heed to the word that I manifest. I manifest the future, the present, followed by the past. Everything in nature rules by kicking ass. What they telling me? But yo, you a friend to me. So I'ma tell you the secrets of MC longevity. Secret one, if it ain't fun, you're done. And about your career, well, choose another one. If you don't like